By the title, you might have already noticed that this is a sponsor. And I'm excited to check GAOMON's PD156 Pro pen display out. Although my content on YouTube mainly focuses on Five Nights at Freddy's Source Filmmaker animations, I basically draw just as much as I animate. I did do some drawing related videos on here, but not much. If you do want to check out the Fnaf drawings that I make, I post those on Instagram, which I will also link into the description. This tablet got sent to me for free. And in exchange for that, I'm making a review on it. Just some notes before that. I'm not a fluent English speaker, as you might have heard. My accent will probably be quite audible, and I had to use my phone when recording things outside from the PC screen. So let's take a look at the package that arrived through Amazon. The box arrived, and it weighed a lot to me. So it weighed 3.6 kilograms. I was surprised by the weight. But weirdly enough, a majority of it was actually the weight of the packaging. The tablet for its size is actually quite light, although I won't be showing every single bit of it because I realized that the flickering was quite annoying. Here you can basically see how good I am at accidentally hurting myself in the dumbest ways. This example, a sticker has caused me to hit my thumb on the scissor for some reason and on the edge of the box. I don't know how. Don't ask. Also, we got an assassination attempt by my old drawing tablet. Nice try, but luckily GAOMON is very durable. I did not intend to make a durability test, but I didn't see anything on that part. So you have a little extra protector thing. You're going to receive the pen display tablet. If you downloaded the driver, which is also linked, you'll be able to adjust everything the way you want to. Installing the driver was so easy. All you needed to do was follow this link and download the PD156 Pro driver for either Windows or Mac, and you're good to go. Here you also have an overview where you can see those buttons and choose them, and then switch to different shortcuts. So yeah. You can go crazy with that. This display is using a Type-C input, and you'll of course get the cable that you require for this. You'll get a digital pen, you'll get a pen holder, and in the pen holder, when you open it, you have 8 extra nibs. And personally, I don't think you'll be able to use all of them, unless you're a psychopath and I don't know what you're doing to those nibs, but yeah. When we go to the pen itself, it's pretty light. You'll also get a USB Y cable or a 2-in-1 cable, which I would recommend. There you have the power option, and you'll get a power adapter. The power adapter doesn't have the plug yet, but you have, at least I had 2 options, and I had to use the EU one because I'm in Germany. They also have a US standard and a AU standard, and I'm guessing depending on where you live, it has some different plug. You'll get a quick start guide, which I'm currently reading from. You also get a warranty card and a glove. Now the glove, I tried to use it. I'd say it was way too big for me because I have little tiny small gremlin hands. The glove is only going to be around your pinky and your ring finger, and the rest is free so that you can hold the pen correctly. You'll of course get everything you need to set it up. However, connecting the cables correctly has given me some difficulties, so it took me 2 extra days until I finally could set it up. I did need to buy something, but some of you might already have these things at home. Mine showed no signal and a red light since I plugged it in the wrong way. It actually tells you to plug the HDMI into the motherboard, so not the monitor, since it usually doesn't have an independent processor, from what I understood. The cables that come with the display might have all the outputs you require. However, the cables are extremely short. I went to some stores to get an extension for an HDMI cable. In that case, you'll need one for the USB cable as well, which I already had at home though, so I didn't need to buy that. I'm pretty sure that not everybody has their PC right next to the monitor. Be aware that you'll probably need an extension cable for both HDMI and USB. I'm guessing that a laptop won't have the too short cable problem, since you probably have it right next to the display. But enough of that, let's just see what happens now that I finally got the extra cables. It worked.
Yes.
You'll see that on the green light here. Yeah, it was quite messy. You have tons of cables and it was a bit hard to set it into the back of my PC. It only got better after the cable problem. when it worked. Oh my gosh. So yeah, again, keep in mind, don't plug it into the monitor, plug it into the PC, into the graphic card. Trust me, I was so happy when it worked, and usually you wouldn't get that problem. Once I set everything up, it was so much fun to draw. I've never had this pen pressure level experience. It has 8,191 pressure levels, which means those are quite a lot. You can pressure test the pen in the driver download thing app. But yeah, you can see the more you put pressure onto the screen, the bigger the line gets, and you can make thin and bigger lines. You can also adjust the sensitivity, and I think you can also calibrate a little bit of the pen if it is a bit off. It might take a few drawings in order for you to get used to it if you don't have a pen display before, but it's so helpful and you'll adjust to it. So my main focus will be on fire alpaca, so keep that in mind. If you use different kind of tools or like different kind of softwares, it might vary. I got pretty used to this quickly, and it's definitely a step up from trying to draw blindly on a non-display drawing tablet. Now I can actually see what I'm drawing directly on. Now, coming to a conclusion, I definitely say that this pen display has a good price. The setup might be tedious when it comes to the cables, since those cannot be avoided and a PC or laptop is required in order for it to work, but it's so much more fun to draw with it. It's big, has a nice shortcut option, and the rest is easy to understand. Be prepared for the size though, you need to have enough space. You had a good overview on the packaging, and you also have tons of shortcuts on the left side of your little display. Well, not little, it's quite big actually. And now I'm used to HD. I'm not sure how it's for people who are like used to 4K. I would say maybe they need to get used to it a little bit more, but this is a drawing tablet and it's not intended for viewing purposes. So keep that in mind. The pen is really light. I'm not used to pen pressure, so I need to still get a bit used to having way thicker lines when I press onto the screen a bit harder. I'm sure you can turn it off. I'm just gonna keep it because I want to use that. When it comes to taking it with you, I'd also say it's flat, which is really awesome. I like how they managed to put it in there, and of course it needs to have that big size. However, I wouldn't dare to put it into my backpack. My backpack is a bit smaller. That's the advantage of like a non-screen tablet. It's really small, depending on which you get, and you can take it with you easily with one single cable attached to it. I love the shortcuts, and on the left side you have tons of buttons, and those are all shortcuts which you can use and also adjust. So what I did is I went to my drawing program, I looked up the shortcuts that I wanted, and then I placed them here. You need to enter a name for the keystroke, and I chose the keyboard obviously because I need a keyboard combination in order to get specific tools. This is going to be a huge upgrade for me, and it is already, judging by what I've already experienced with it in comparison to my very first and only drawing tablet. It doesn't compare even close to the new one, and I'm sorry little one, this little drawing tablet, well, it went through some stuff. I think maybe it's happy. I think it's probably happy about not being able to be used again. Yeah, I think that thing suffered enough. While you see me drawing a Freddy on it, here are some infos about the GAOMON PD156 Pro. So it's a 15.6-inch laminated graphic display with 88% NTSC color space. I don't exactly understand what that means, but when I searched definitions for it, GAOMON mentioned on their blog that over 85% NTSC means that it's an excellent screen, so there's that. The screen itself shows 16.7 million different colors, and that's a big number. It also has a dial function with an anti-reflection coating. You have an HD screen. Thanks to its size, you have a 178 degree viewing angle. The pen is battery free, so you only need to charge the pen display itself. You can tilt your pen up to 60 degrees, but I noticed that the calibration is slightly off when it's tilted, but that's not too bad in my opinion. It comes with a nice stand, which you can use to place it onto and change the degree angle that you are looking at. It has 9 shortcut keys, or shortcut buttons, and now to sum it all up, it is compatible with Windows and Mac. Here you also have a little overview from GAOMON on what what programs you can use it for, in terms of drawing programs, of course. I've always been using Fire Alpaca personally, so I'll stick with that. I've never had a pen display, so I can't really say anything about other brands, but just the only tedious thing to me was the cable thing. My PC, for example, was a bit farther away from the monitor, so it depends. Just get some extensions, or if you already have those, then you're good to go. And I didn't need to change anything, any of my settings. I just needed to put my shortcuts onto it. Now I'm definitely having more fun at drawing digitally, and it really showed me how much fun it can be. I've become accustomed to it. I don't see any issues. It's easy to understand. You have the instructions too, so it's pretty simple. Simple setup, quick setup. Just make sure you have long cables. Do your thing. You can draw a stickman. You can draw cursed drawings. You can draw a Lego. You can draw someone drawing a drawing. You can draw everything you want to. I hope I could give a good insight into the GAOMON PD156 Pro pen display, and I'll see you in the next video when I talk again. I did want to do merchandise videos, but I haven't been confident enough. I really want to do more commentary, but it's just I always don't dare to because I'm embarrassing. I'm really bad at talking. One more thing that I wanted to add at the end is that GAOMON is actually holding a 7-day deal promotion from March 28th to April the 3rd on American stores. So if you place an order for the PD156 Pro during this period, you will get a 15% discount. Everything will be linked down in the description, so if you want to check it out, just go down there. Thank you guys so much for sticking around the entire time, and we've come to an end. I'm not sure how long this video is going to be. I wanted to keep it short. I'm just gonna make some weird noises. I'm dying. Okay. I'm still alive. Yeah. It's nice. Okay.